blessing from the disturbance of all the teachers. Dear beloved, the grace of God, our Savior, has appeared to all men, instructing us that denying ungodliness, worldly desires, we should live so good, justly, and godly in this world, looking for the blessed hope, for the coming of the glory of the great God and of our Savior Jesus Christ. He gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity, that he might cleanse to himself a people acceptable, a pursuer of good works. These things speak, exalt in Christ Jesus our Lord. The translation of the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke. At that time, there went out the decree from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This enrolling was first made by Severus, the governor of Syria. And all went to be enrolled, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house of and family of David, to be enrolled with Mary's espoused wife, who was with child. And it came to pass that when they were there, her days were accomplished, that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn, the son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds keeping the night watches over their flock. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood by them, and the brightness of God shone round about them, and they feared the great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy that shall be to all the people. For this day is born to you a Savior, who is Christ the Lord in the city of David. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the infant wrapped in swaddling cloth, laid in a manger." And suddenly there was to the angel a multitude of the heavenly army, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of good will." These are the words of the gospel. Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. And the Savior is born to us. As we celebrate, my dear brethren, this joyous Noel, Buena tarde, Feliz Navidad, Merry Christmas, we transcend borders, countries, time, human force, logics are defeated. What are we doing here tonight, in the middle of the night? And there, wherever it is, what were we doing yesterday and tomorrow and next year? Since this initial event of the birth of our Lord. Yes, indeed. We gather tonight to celebrate an event that has consequences for the whole creation. However, this birth, as every birth, by the way, does not stop to this actual child. This child that you contemplate, it goes through. This child, and it is true for every child of the world, belong to a family. Close extent. He is the fruit of a whole civilization, of art of life, a culture, in which he will grow, and from which he will gain. And that particular child, and that is not true for every child, belongs to the particular tribe of David, the king of Israel, the tribe from which the Messiah, the Redeemer, the new king, is to come. Indeed, this child, and that is true for every child, has a mission to fulfill, a particular vocation to accomplish. That's true for us as well. The same way that we have all received at birth. And that mission is to praise God, to adore Him, to serve Him, to love Him, and to say the word. But this particular baby that we adore tonight, laying in the manger, the means that he had are far more than what we do. But the mission is the same. This child, and that counts for all of us, for every child in the world, this child has a mother, the most perfect of all. That is the first one that the shepherd found in the manger. The evangelists say they enter into the manger and they found the mother and the child, as it is natural. How could a child be without a mother? And this child, Jesus, and that is true for every child, has a father. Joseph is not his name. Our dear Saint Joseph's spouse, the Blessed Virgin Mary, is a guardian, the protector, the keeper of the secret that is revealed tonight. Jesus is not the child of Joseph, as many thought. And that is definitively not. Like any other child, Jesus is the Son of God and God Himself. Incredible revolution, incredible revelation. God as a Son since eternity. If ever we can put together since and ever eternity. From eternity, how do we say? God is triune. He is Father, He is Son, He is Holy Ghost. Three together, one and distant. Yes, my dear brethren, the great revelation of this night is the Blessed Trinity. And as we contemplate the manger, that is what we can see. The Son of God, Jesus, reveals to us the Father. His birth on earth explores everything, gives sense to mankind. Pope Benedict says, Jesus brings to completion the love of the Father for us, because he is the love of God. He is entirely so. And he invites us, each one of us, to become sons and daughters according to this creed. That is from the birth of the creed that we find the foundation of his possibility to say, to dare to say, our Father, who art in heaven. In this manner, it is not only the infant Jesus that we contemplate, it is our brother. And looking at Jesus, we discover who truly we are and how we need to be to fulfill the vocations that we have to be sons and daughters of God. Created as his image, we are not ready-made children of God. No, no, no. Not from the start. But one meant to become so increasingly by growing more and more in communion with Jesus. I wish you, my dear brethren, a Merry Christmas today. Is to say, let us restore in our soul this wonderful life, this wonderful image of our Jesus Christ. Let us rediscover the infancy, the spirit of a child that was once ours, and humbly ask God to transform our heart, that he might come in, because, as we always say, we need to make room for him in our own heart. May God wish you a very Merry Christmas.